Yep, that easy. The best ball of the year, I don't care what anyone says, is this dang. If you haven't tried it by now, then you're just not doing something right. All right, what's going on, everyone? We're gonna dive into what are the best balls from this last PBA tour. Really the ones I was using, but I got some other ones here. This tour for the Storm, Roto, and 900 global brands. For me, this was kind of the year of the ASIM pearls, shinier balls. I think these were, in my opinion, the best options that we had. So the options for those were, one was the Vibo. You saw a lot of guys throwing this, you saw a lot of guys throwing it on tour. This ball in general, really clean cover. And like for me, if you're wanting that clean ball and almost like, well, you know, you would maybe refer to as like a hockey stick reaction, this is your bowling ball. So you can see even on that shot there, I was able to, I mean, I was trying to roll it. And you see that ball just glides down the lane and makes a left turn. So for me this year, seeing that, it's not necessarily a motion that I love. I wasn't able to use this a lot because at times, at least on tour, it was so much down lane motion, which, you know, is a good thing. I think you would rather be able to have options that give you, you know, too much hook than a ball, you know, never hooking. This ball was one of the most used balls on tour. We saw everyone throwing it. It's got a great cover on it, makes a great motion, and heard a lot of great things from people using it in league. But this was one of the, definitely the best balls. Oh, I even tugged that. Jeez, whew. Clearly it's so good you can hit either side of the pocket. So that's the first one. That's the first clean ASIM that we saw people throwing literally all the time. The second one was the coil. So it's from the Storm line, another shiny ball, another shiny ASIM. Saw a ton of people using this. We bowled a lot of medium patterns, long patterns. And for me, I think the Vibo was a little cleaner, a little more down lane. The coil likes to, what we call, get a little forward. It likes to roll, not as much as that hockey stick reaction down lane. It likes to go a little straighter off the pattern, which is good for guys that, you know, maybe have a little higher rev rate. Maybe the Vibo is a little too angular. You could throw something like this coil. So I, again, didn't really throw this ball a whole lot this year, but I've been wanting to because I've seen so many guys. I think Stu Williams whacked him at Open Championships with the ball, so I gotta give it a try for sure. Yeah, and I don't know if you can tell, but that ball for me just, it goes a little more forward off the spot, which, you know, it makes sense on tour why guys are liking it, because you need a clean cover, but it's giving you a reaction that's controllable down lane. Saw a ton of guys throwing that. Now, you already know from watching the vlogs and everything that there's another clean asymmetric ball that came out this year. And that was the King Daddy. I am biased because this one was like the best of both worlds. You know when you just have a ball, when you drill it, that even if it's giving you an okay reaction, when it gets to the 1-3, it just knocks down the pins. And that was the attention star from Roto Grip this year. This ball for me was the most universal. It was clean, it blended out the lane. And for me, it was almost in between the Vibo and the coil. Coil would get a little forward, the Vibo was a little too much. This ball was like right in the middle, and you know, if I needed to hook it, this ball just blended out the lane and allowed me to control the pocket. But again, you know, that was on the PBA Tour. PBA Tour patterns play a lot different than all the other patterns we see, so maybe it was just a tour ball. Oh. You know, and I say it just knocks over pins, and first shot, ring 10. But we got super forward with that one. I just feel like with the attention star, I can just control the pocket so well, and it's so clean and still stores energy that it's been amazing. But dude, I was able to throw this ball. We bowled the World Series of Bowling. I threw this ball on Cheetah once there was some carry down to go down the lane. Threw it on, so Cheetah's like what, 35 feet, 34 feet, something like that. Threw it on Shark, which is like 48 feet. And what was it, Scorpion? That's like 42 feet. So a clear variety of patterns there. And I was able to make this ball work well on all of them. And I've heard so many good things about this ball. Yeah, this ball is a monster. Out of all the balls that have came out, I think I've heard the most consistent news from the Attention Star. I think they're still in like back order because everyone needs them. Because this is one of those balls that, don't say this often, but everyone needs to try. I've heard so many good, I only know one guy that doesn't like his Attention Star, and he's left-handed, so. He's actually sitting over there right now. And lefty, so you know, how much stock can I really put in that opinion? Yeah, the attention start for me was a game changer. I was able to use it in multiple different centers, multiple different patterns. It's just a fancy, it's not too clean, it's not too strong, it's just somewhere right in the middle. I got on that one. Yeah, I mean, that ball is the ball that's going everywhere with me. It was the ball that made me exempt on tour for next year, the ball that gave me hope. It turned me from being not feeling great about my game to giving me a ball reaction that, man, I'm pretty good. So this year for sure, the three clean ASIMs, we seem to throw those balls a lot. The Vibo, the Coil, and the Attention Star. And the good thing is that they're all a little different. So depending on what people's games were, you were able to throw, you know, either one of them. Some people preferred the Vibos, some people preferred the Attention Star, some the Coil. So it's great to have, you know, different options. We don't want them all rolling the same. So let's get to some other balls here. Another ball that was thrown a ton to kind of control the lane a little bit more was the new Optimum Idle. Now this isn't a ball you're gonna be wheeling and dealing the lane with. That's for those asymmetric pearls. This is gonna be a ball where you're gonna control the front to back motion a lot. You're gonna use this on like short patterns, medium patterns, stuff where when the lanes get a little choppy out there, you're gonna have a consistent reaction. So I haven't thrown this ball. I drilled this one pinned down. I saw a lot of guys using this. Troop used this a lot. He used it on the playoffs. I was able to use this ball on short. I'm gonna move a little further right here and go up the lane because this ball should be a lot smoother for me. Yeah, so I got to do some readjusting there because the other bone balls I had, they're going to respond to friction a lot quicker. This idle's not going to do that. It's not designed to do that. It's going to be a lot smoother off of it. So I kind of had to feel those balls that I really like to hook, especially a lot down lane. So I'm going to have to go a lot straighter with this ball. But this is like a, this is, you know, when we talk bone balls, this is a control ball. This is a ball that when the lane's a little harder, you know, nationals, you're bowling on harder stuff. Optimum Idle was money. It just allows you to control the lane without doing anything like super crazy down lane. So that was really a bad shot. I'm bowling on a sport pattern here, 41 feet. If I swing it way out to the right, it's just not coming back. So I'm gonna move right and try to roll this one a little bit better. Yeah, that shot was a lot more up the lane, a lot less angle, still held its line to the pocket. If I threw the other balls in that same spot, they probably wouldn't have held their line as well. So Optimum Model was a great choice for a lot of people on the fresh. Once the transition started happening, you saw guys get out of the Optimum Model because it's not the greatest ball for standing left and wheeling right. We have other options for that. And again, I threw the Optimum Model a little bit. This next ball I liked for that spot way more, and that is the Tour Dynamics. So low diff ball, pretty strong cover. And again, this is a ball where you're gonna roll the ball up the lane a little bit more. Control your angles in the front. I love this ball. I drilled them all pretty much pin up, super standard layout. I threw 1,000 on this to start and it just allowed me to keep my angles in front of me. It almost gave me the closest thing you can get to a urethane reaction out of a reactive ball. I could be a little more aggressive with my hand, have a little leeway, go up the lane, it would still hold its line. So this kind of fits in a little bit of the same category as what the Idle does. So I'm gonna play the same place I just did with that and try to roll it. God, my grips are so big. Forgot to change them out from the TOC. All right, so we're just kind of rolling this ball, staying up the back. This is pretty much the zone I like to use this ball in. Oh, I tugged it. Okay, user error. Man, it's terrible. I gotta practice a lot to be able to go straight up the lane. I haven't bowled in a couple weeks. But even that ball, I mean, it rolled pretty well. It didn't, I was never going elbow flied. I was never gonna hold its line, but it still didn't make like a crazy snappy reaction. But again, another ball on the fresh. I love this ball. I really didn't see like enough guys throwing it. I know Belmo used it a little bit, but it didn't get used as much as I thought would. So I don't know, maybe it's just something that fit my game, but I really like it for keeping your angles just a little more in front of you. All right, stay tall, throw a good shot. All right, so let's see. Yeah, and it's still reactive. So, you know, I talked about it being close to the urethane. It's still a reactive ball, so it's still gonna give you that energy through the pins. It's still gonna go through it. But for me, I feel like, you know, maybe the middle part of the lane's really flat and you gotta play, you know, up it, maybe keep your speed up a little bit. Really like this ball for that type of shape. I'll throw another one just cause I missed this ball. I was throwing this ball at the TOC And I would call this a conditional ball. It's not a ball I think you can use all the time, but when it's the right time in the right place, it's great. And I would use this ball for the first two games of every block for the TOC. When everyone else was throwing urethane, I was able to just roll this ball. It was nice and smooth. Urethane wasn't looking great for me, but then I would put it away immediately. Even if I had like a 220 game, I knew that I had to start migrating left, and this ball doesn't like a ton of left to right shape for the most part. So I'd go to attention star. But yeah, I would just, in the right place at the right time, this ball is extremely valuable. So let's try this, see if we can throw it to it early. Stay tall. Oh, yeah, that's what I miss about that ball. I can just get away with the little errors in my hand when I'm going up the lane. And you guys know that, sometimes reactive, it's hard to just roll the ball up the lane because it wants to break loose. This ball doesn't like to break loose for me. So even that shot, I feel like I got away with it and it's still like dead flush. So we've gone through, got the clean A-sims. Again, I still think it was the year of like the cleaner A-sims. Guys using a ton of those. Went through a couple control balls. Those were the newer balls out that really did well. At the end of the tour season, we were introduced to the Road. Symmetrical, clean ball as well. You know, we had a couple options, like the gold label. It was a gap that we really needed to fill on tour. Just a clean, symmetrical ball that is gonna get down the lane and definitely store more energy. And that's what this ball did. When you wanna get in and kind of wheel the lane a little bit, this is a great ball for that, especially when the lanes are burnt up. So we don't have burnt up lanes though. We have fresh, which sometimes makes it difficult to throw these balls, but for the sake of it, I'm gonna move about 7 left with my feet and see what this ball does. Oh, Kyle, what was that? Thought we were getting away with it. It was a heartbreaker. I got that ball a little further right, and the ball's so clean, but it fortunately saw the friction and came back and struck. It's not surprising I left like a ring 10. Like, that wasn't too much of a flat 10. This ball is gonna ring a couple 10s right now because it's just gonna get behind the pocket, I would think. But let me try to throw a better shot. But again, symmetrical, clean option. Guys were definitely giving this one a go quite a bit. I hit it more. Man, we just can't get a breakout here. This fresh oil, you're not really gonna use the Road a whole lot. I would need to like square my angle up and fit it in there a little bit. I wouldn't do that. I would just take one of my control options, Tour Dynamics or the Idle if I wanted to play that zone. Or if I'm gonna hook it, I'm gonna use one of these stronger balls. Now, if I was gonna bowl like a 6-game block, best believe this ball is coming out on like, you know, game 4. Once my ace and pearls are burning up, I gotta move my angle in a little bit. See if we can throw a strike with this one. I kept it a little more in. Yeah, you see that one. Lanes just aren't dry enough for it, which is good. Again, we gotta have variety in bowling balls. And that was like a little better spot down lane that I hit. I rolled it a little bit better. And you see, it's just weak right now. Came up light. The other balls in that area were coming up a little stronger and getting flush, which they're designed to do. But I'm telling you, when the lanes get dry, the Road is super good. I'm pretty sure it came out like mid-tour. And it was a great, like, here you go, guys. We know you need this. We know you need another ball when the lanes get burnt up at the end of the block that you can get in and wheel it. Here you go. Same thing with the blackout. I didn't bring the blackout out because I didn't use that a whole lot. That one came out, I think, even later than that one. We got that at, like, maybe the World Series or the TOC. It's like one of the last tournaments of the year. So I didn't get to throw that one a whole lot. That's why I didn't make the video for the best balls on the PBA Tour. It came out a few tournaments earlier. We would have added it. But again, you're the ace in pearls, the coil, the Vibo, the attention star, all good, the optimum idle. And I threw in the Tour Dynamics. I don't know if it's classified as one of the best balls because I don't know if I saw enough guys throwing it, but I freaking love that ball. And then you have to throw in the IQ78U, the urethane that was designed, I guess, for us to throw on tour with all the crazy hardness urethane rules that are out there now. They gave us this ball, and dude, the first tournament out of the box was the Players Championship this year. You know, we were a little worried that, you know, a harder urethane ball, it's just not gonna hook as much, or we're afraid it's not gonna hook as much. And guys threw this at the Players Championship, the first term of the year, and never looked back. I mean, I thought there was gonna be a learning curve, or maybe there wasn't as much urethane being thrown. Nah, PBA guys are too good. They were able to throw this ball, hook it, even though it's a harder cover, which is just gonna go a little bit straighter. Now, like, your plastic balls are the hardest covers that you can possibly make, and they go pretty straight. So this is just a harder cover than the other urethanes. So the guys were still able to hook it. So let's see if we can throw a strike with this. Pretty much on any medium pattern, you're just playing around 10 and just ripping the holes off of it. So that's what I'm gonna do. Yep, that easy. Thought it was gonna go straighter. And it does a little bit more than the pitch black, but it was still extremely useful. You saw guys throwing that 78U pretty much all tour season. Especially the higher rev rate guys could get away with it. Actually, even some of the lower rev rate guys could get away with it because it forced you to play your angles a little straighter. Straighter angles, you're generally gonna carry a little bit more, especially with throwing urethane. You start swinging that urethane ball too much, you start ragging tens unless you're really, really hammer on it. But apparently that ball was definitely one of the best balls this year. The only urethane we could throw this year. But thank you, Storm, for you know, putting together a good one for us. So there you have it, guys. The best balls of the 2024 PBA Tour season, in my opinion. I think Brad has a couple other options that he thinks are good. But in my opinion, these were the balls that some of the other guys were using, some of what we were using. The best ball of the year, I don't care what anyone says, is this dang attention star. If you haven't tried it by now, then you're just not doing something right. So if you're someone that likes to throw a Storm, Roto Grip, 900 Global, if you're a fan of any of those brands, just give this ball a shot. There's a 92% chance, based off all the research I've done, that you'll like it. And if you throw other companies, you should probably still give this ball a try. It was awesome for me. I hope it's awesome for you. But yeah, that's a little review of the balls that were used this tour season. Maybe you're questioning what kind of ball you're gonna get, or you're a little confused. Hopefully, you know, this wasn't a crazy ball review, but I wanted to get the ones that, you know, we think are the best out there. There's a lot of bone balls you can choose from, and we really like these select few that I picked here today. So anyway, best balls of the 2024 season. Hope you guys like that. Make sure you like and subscribe. We'll see you in the next one. Shabam!